What's up everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I made my way down to Lamborghini Charlotte and we're going to take a look at a 2020 Lamborghini Aventador SVJ. Huge shout out to them for providing this vehicle for me today. I'll have their information down in the description below. Definitely check them out. But this model here is finished off in Arancio Atlas and it has an MSRP just under $564,000. And also don't forget about our GoPro giveaway for January. More details on that will be later in this video. The Lamborghini Aventador SVJ is a mid-engine supercar. Up underneath, this has a 6.5-liter naturally aspirated V12 engine, only paired to the 7-speed ISR single clutch transmission. As you just saw, in order to see the complete engine bay, you do have to unclip both sides of the hatch, and then with two people, you can easily remove this hatch, and it is carbon fiber, so it's very lightweight and easy to move around. This engine produces 770 horsepower and 531 pound-feet of torque. It is all-wheel drive, weighs around 3,300 pounds, it'll do 0 to 60 in 2.7 seconds, and 0 to 125 in 8.8 seconds, and its top speed is 217 miles an hour. Starting up front on the 2020 Aventador SVJ, we'll take a look at the headlight housing. They are LED. This has LED daytime running lights as well, which have a nice Y-shaped design to them. Right on the inside, we have these 7 hexagonal shaped designs. These are the turn signals, which gives it a really unique look. As we make our way to the center of the vehicle, you'll see this carbon fiber piece running throughout the middle. And then down below on the gloss black front splitter, it says ALA. This is Lamborghini's aerodynamic system. There's two flaps on the lower section here that will deploy at speed to help improve with aerodynamics. And as you can tell on the top section of the front bumper, there are cutouts as well. Again, to help with the aerodynamics of this vehicle, you can see the channels running up the top of the hood here, just gives it a more of an aggressive design. And then down below, there are a ton of cutouts to, again, to help provide with more airflow. On each side of the vehicle, there's some added fins to help guide the airflow around. And then as we make our way up to the hood again, you'll see there's carbon fiber on the back side of it. Overall, this has a very low and wide front appearance. Moving to the side of the 2020 SVJ, we'll start out with these wheels. They have a 10-spoke design to them. They measure 20 by 9 in the front and 21 by 13 in the rear. They have a nice silver finish to them as well. And then this does have carbon ceramic brakes. You can see the calipers are body colored, which gives it a really nice look. This has 6 piston calipers up front with 4 piston in the rear. And the front rotors measure 400 millimeters and 380 millimeters in the rear. Working our way up to the side mirrors, they are finished off in carbon fiber, have a really nice look to them. You can see down below is the gloss black side skirt, has a really nice fin to it just behind the front tire. And then you can see there's a very unique shape in the door. It really curves in, following this line all the way to behind the front tire again. Just behind the door, you'll see a gas cap along with a huge air inlet to one of the radiators mounted on the sides. This will provide all the airflow. You'll see it channel down the door and right into that. It's a very large air inlet, so this vehicle definitely doesn't have any issues with airflow to the engine. Just behind that, you'll see a gloss black trim piece along with the Italian flag colors. Gives it a really nice look. And then just above the rear tire, you'll see the SVJ logo. There's more gloss black trim on the engine cover. Overall, it has a really aggressive side profile to it, and it's super low at the same time. You can see me standing next to it. I'm 5'10", and it's probably right in line with my midsection here. So it's a very low car. All these lines are super aggressive as well. But while we're on the side of the vehicle, let's go ahead and take a look at the doors. You just have to go up underneath. There's an electronic button, and then I think our favorite part that everyone loves about the Lamborghini is the doors. I really love how they go up and down. And finishing up in the rear with the 2020 SVJ, we'll start with the massive carbon fiber wing. This has the ALA technology in it as well. So basically, airflow will go through the engine bay into air inlets that will guide it through the spoiler and back out underneath. So not only will that help with aerodynamics, but it will also help with downforce when the vehicle is at speed. Right in the center, we have the third brake light along with Lamborghini and the backup camera. This does have LED taillights, and you can see the turn signals have the Y-shaped pattern to them, just like up front, which is very nice how they integrated that all together. Right in the middle, we have the dual exhaust, which you'll hear soon. And then on each side, you can see there are large cutouts to provide heat extraction from the engine. There's also more cutouts down below. You can see there are parking sensors throughout the massive carbon fiber diffuser with very aggressive slats running down in the middle. So you definitely have plenty of airflow and aerodynamics on the rear end of this vehicle. So that is going to finish it up for the exterior walk around on the 2020 Lamborghini Aventador SVJ. What a car to be able to check out. I absolutely love this color. But let's go ahead and take a look at the inside now that we've seen all the exterior features. All I have to do is place my hand up underneath the electronic button and we can easily open it up. That is my favorite part right there, seeing that door do that. And then obviously you can tell on the inside, this has carbon fiber along the entire door sill. You have some buttons on the backside. If you do need to tow this vehicle, you can shut off the alarms and things like that. That is pretty much it on the door panel. You have a leather strap here as the grab handle to close the door with your lock and unlock, your side mirror adjustments. They are heated as well, and one speaker. All right, so hopping into the Aventador SVJ. Very lightweight door, so you can easily close it. In order to get out, there's a latch down below, so you just use that with your left hand and then kind of push up just a little bit, and then it will take care of the rest and easily open up. So it's very easy to get in and out, even though the door is kind of like right there. But now in the driver's seat here, we have leather on the steering wheel. There's Alcantara on the tops and the bottom, along with an orange stripe right in the middle. Has pretty good hand positioning on both sides. I really like the notches. And then you have the column mounted paddle shifters right behind that, so very easy within reach to do. Moving on to the seats, right off the bat, I can see all the carbon fiber on the back side of them. Along with the cutout, we have Alcantara and stitching running down them, along with the Y design, so you can see it on the exterior and it's carried on to the interior, along with the SVJ badge over on one side. Moving on to the controls on the steering wheel, you have your volume on one side along with the voice command, and then you can change the radio and different modes on the left side. As we make our way to the left side of the steering wheel, you'll see all the toggle switches for the headlights, along with the daytime running lights. Down below is how we open up the front storage space, which I'll get to here soon. You can see leather and orange piping on the dash, along with stitching and Alcantara. That badge over there says 1 of 900, which is really cool to see. There's carbon fiber up top, and it covers the entire gauge cluster right in the middle. As you can see, over on the left side is the radio right now. If we click on mode, you can pull up some other vital information. Right in the middle, we have the tach with the gear selection right in the center, and some other vital information. And then off into the right side, you have your miles until empty, along with your fuel gauge and engine temperature. As we make our way to the center, you'll see more Alcantara and stitching, gives it a really nice look. Before we get to all the controls in the center, let's go ahead and fire this up. With my foot on the brake, we'll just go ahead and flip the red cap up and then hold the engine start button. Obviously, that sounds incredible between the different driving modes. So I was going between Strada, Sport, and Corsa. There's also an Ego mode down below, and all you have to do is push on these buttons here to correspond to what driving mode you'd like to go to. And then up top, we have the screen. It's very easy to use that. All of the controls are down on the back side here. We have navigation, info, car, and setup with your controls in the center, the rotary dial, and then radio, media, and your phone over on the right side. So just clicking on the navigation, you'll see up top we can pull up the map, so you can easily view that. We can click on car, and you can see some other information that you can scroll through, your wiper blades, parking system, things like that. We can go to the radio. You have your media if you want to hook up your phone, along with being able to go to your phone. Just below that, we have some more toggle switches. You have your window controls for driver and passenger, the front end lift, you can turn off traction control. You have your hazards, the engine start stop feature, and then the passenger side window. All of your AC controls are right in the middle, and you'll see that pop up top. So right now we have the temperature. If I click on where you'd like the air to go, you can see a nice graphic appear. And then we also have the fan speed. So very nice that you see that. We have the driving modes and the engine start stop button that I already showed, along with power and volume for the radio. Working our way to the middle here, you'll see reverse. You have the manual mode, so you can activate the paddle shifters, and then we have the parking brake right in the center. Very nice leather and Alcantara in the center, along with the orange piping. You can see behind the seats, there's a 12 volt, along with a little bit of storage space. This is usable for jackets or small bags or something like that. And then as we make our way over to the passenger side, you'll see Lamborghini with more Alcantara and stitching. There's a little compartment here for a phone or something like that. And then we'll take one last look at these seats with the carbon fiber and the orange Y shape going down the middle. Very comfortable seats. It even extends all the way to the headliner with the orange piping. And last up, we'll go ahead and take a look at the front storage space, which is nice to see in a mid-engine vehicle. There's a latch up underneath that you just grab on so we can easily open it up. You can see you do have some additional storage space up front. There's a small bag here and a box right there, just kind of for some reference, along with a cover on the backside. You do have this middle divider that's part of government regulations, but either way, you still have usable storage space, which is nice to see. That's gonna wrap up taking a look at the all-new 2020 Lamborghini Aventador SVJ. Once again, huge shout out to Lamborghini Charlotte for providing this vehicle for me today. We will not be going on a test drive because it is a brand new vehicle, but Brian just reviewed the 2016 SV sitting over there, so I will have that video down below. Definitely check that out to see how it drives. That's gonna wrap it up. Don't forget about the GoPro for January. All you have to do is be a subscriber and comment on videos. We're gonna pick the video with the most comments at the end of January and send out the GoPro. So make sure you subscribe and comment, and I'll see you guys in the next video.